Alright, so who would like to start us out and talk about what happened in chapters 14 and 15? Ollie?
I don't really remember.
He was trying to rent a factory, and he hired Hector, and he was trying to get the machine, and that cost $15,000.
Okay.
And Hector's, I think Hector said in the story that he'll help Rufus and Kate assemble it.
So, what did they try to do to get the money for the machine?
Ooh.
And then pass it to Dontavius.
He tried to ask somebody, which was the teacher.
Was it the teacher that he asked first?
Mr.
Pooney. I think they asked.
Or come loud.
I think they went to a bank and asked for money, but the man said no.
Okay.
Because they were too young.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so then what did they do, Ollie?
Then they went to Mr. Pooney.
And what did he say?
No, because you're too young and, you're too young to have a business like that.
Where does it say that in the text, that the teacher said that?
What page is it?
Well, I'm not sure. That's why I'm asking what you're referencing.
It said once when he went to the teacher, he said, you're too young to run a business.
Okay, find that part that you're talking about, and let's look at that.
Oh, I remember reading that part.
Where's your book?
I remember reading on that chapter.
Hector? Alright, so I read it probably on page... Here, page 75.
Alright. So who are they talking to in that part?
They're talking to Mr.
Perkle. Who was Mr. Perkle?
Oh.
Was he their teacher?
No.
He's not, so you're confused.
I know.
Someone pass the mic to Jackson, let him tell you what he thinks.
I think it was like the bank manager or the boss of that bank.
So where does it tell us that he went to a bank?
That's the principal.
So you're looking at the picture and you're thinking it's the principal, but let's read chapter 14 and see if you're right. The trouble with adults.
Wait, I'm not there yet.
Page 71. So let's go back, Ollie, and let's listen to this and see. Is this the principal or the teacher? Rufus did think I was a little out of my mind when I told him I had found him not only a toothpaste machine, but a whole factory and a mechanic to go with it. And he did wonder if we couldn't somehow get to use the machine without hiring Hector as well. I tried to explain that Hector and the machine seemed to belong together and that I didn't think we could get one.
He's too young on page 77.
But is that just the teacher or the principal? That's what we need to figure out.
It was a principal.
Let's reread and see. As soon as he met Hector, Rufus understood. And as soon as Hector heard the details of Rufus's plan for keeping the price of toothpaste low and profits high at the same time, he thought it was a beautiful idea. That Happy Lips lotion, Hector said, $1.98 a tube. Nothing in it but a little lanolin and a speck of perfume to make it smell nice. Maybe it made your lips feel nice, but it sure was a high-priced way to feel nice. Hector explained everything about the machine to Rufus, how many tubes it could fill in an hour, how many helpers Hector would need to turn out so many tubes. He and Rufus were talking as if it were all settled that Rufus was going to rent the plant. It would be a shame not to, Rufus said on the way home. We know we've got a good idea. We've got all those tubes, now the machine, and Hector. All we need is a little money. Quite a lot, Rufus, I said. So how much, Rufus said. Let's see. $9,000 for Hector, $3,600 for rent, and maybe a little more in case we have to buy more tubes. I guess we'll need about $15,000. How are you going to get $15,000, I asked. Just walk in a bank and ask for it? Hey, Rufus said, why not? Isn't that what other people do? A stick-up, you mean, I said? No, no, Rufus said, I mean the way other businessmen do, the big businessmen. So what are they talking about right here?
They're talking about...
Just stay focused on this conversation.
They're talking about if they should walk into the bank and ask the bank person if they can have money, like how real business can do. But like Ollie said that he already read the part, but probably as soon as they go,
so then who is this man in this picture, Ollie?
The bank person?
A bank person. Alright, well let's come on. And it's the bank person that said what you're saying.
Was that alright?
Yeah.
What Rufus decided to do was to go to everybody's friendly savings and loan and borrow some money. Everybody's friendly savings and loan was the sponsor of the Joe Smiley Show. Five times every night, this friendly vice president, Seymour Perkle, interrupted the show to do a commercial telling how friendly everybody's friendly savings and loan was about lending everybody money to buy a car or start a business, and how they liked to encourage young businessmen who were starting businesses in the neighborhood, and how they believed in people and how people were their business. The way Mr. Perkle made it sound, everybody's friendly savings and loan was dying to lend everybody money. So Rufus called up the office and asked for an appointment with Mr. Perkle.
Hey, sorry to interrupt. Mrs. Williams wants Smith's closest kids to still go to their special area. I'm just sending out a text for it. It's PE and then art. Can you have your intern either take your class or take Katie's class? One of you two split up and take Katie's class.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to send out the text if that's what's happening. Thank you.
So will everyone send their kids to me then at special area time?
They can do that, or we can just have them line up out in the hall to the side of the door and then have either you or Miss Aikens leave.
Okay, that's fine. I'll do Miss Close's class and Miss Aikens can be one. The way Mr. Perkle made it sound, oops, I already read that. When we got to the office, the lady at the front desk didn't want to let us see Mr. Perkle. She said she had an appointment at 4 o'clock. Rufus said, so do I. My name is Rufus Mayflower, and Mr. Perkle's 4 o'clock appointment is with me. The lady looked at an appointment calendar on her desk and said, oh, you're Mr. Mayflower? I didn't think she expected Mr. Mayflower to look so young. So why did she not think that Rufus, it was his appointment? Jackson.
Because he was young. Most kids don't really run businesses. Bikes, boats.
Okay. Go ahead.
What was the question?
Why didn't the secretary think that it was their appointment?
Because they're so young. Usually, kids can't make appointments.
Okay.
They can't make appointments to this day.
Okay. She called into Mr. Perkle's office to tell him, Mr. Perkle, there is a young man here to see you, and there is a young lady with him. I didn't care for the way she said young, as if Rufus and I were about 4 years old.
Mm-hmm.
But Rufus walked into Mr. Perkle's office as if he'd been borrowing money all his life. Mr. Perkle looked more tired than he did on TV and not as friendly. But he warmed up a little when I told him we saw him every night on the Joe Smiley commercial and that he was very good. Ah, he said, and what can I do for you? You can lend me some money for a business I'm starting, Rufus said. Rufus was on the Joe Smiley Show a couple of weeks ago, I said, as Mr. Perkle looked as if he needed a little more warming up. Joe Smiley says that he got a lot of listener response to that show, and Rufus got orders for 689 jars of toothpaste. Ah, Mr. Perkle said to Rufus, so that's where I've seen you. You're the boy who makes toothpaste. Yes, Rufus said. He explained to Mr. Perkle that he now has 7,200 toothpaste tubes, a machine for filling them, and a man who knew how to run the machine, and that all he needed to get into production was about $15,000. What do you think that means, production, to get into production?
To get
don't know, but I'm just gonna try it.
All right, what do you have?
I think that product is like the main amount of money. Like
it says, plus, he needs. Where is
if you're
it?
Gonna buy something for $5, the most product.
So the word's not product. The word is production. So he said he needed to get into production was $15,000.
Oh, production.
Production.
Yeah, I don't know.
What do you think production means? Boys, would you just divide up your Doritos so you're not back and forth eyeballing each other about sharing them? Just share what you're going to share so that you can be focused on the discussion.
I think okay. It means, like,
well, let's look back and see. So, Ollie, look at page 76. Yes, Rufus said. He explained to Mr. Perkle that he now had 7,200 toothpaste tubes, a machine for filling them, and a man who knew how to run the machine, and that all he needed to get into production was about $15,000. So what does that mean, get into production?
Get into his own business.
Well, it's you're on the right track. So, what does the word produce mean? If I produce something,
make.
What am I doing? I'm making it. So, what do you think production would mean then?
Not making it?
He's got the machines. He's got
making. Like,
yeah, it's making his product. Production would be the making of the product that you're going to sell.
Cool.
So, what does he need in order to get into production?
$15,000.
Money.
Okay. Which he could easily pay back in a year, because within 1 year he could easily be selling 250 million tubes of toothpaste. Rufus had written out on a piece of paper all the facts about the population of the United States and the 1 cent profit. You have a very good idea, Mr. Perkle said, and you have figured everything out in a very businesslike way. So, can you lend me the money today? Rufus asked. Mr. Perkle looked unhappy. I'm afraid I can't lend you the money at all, he said. How come? I thought you lent money to everybody. Well, not everybody exactly, Mr. Perkle said. Not exactly, it turned out, meant not kids. So that's what you were talking about, Ollie. You were saying that the person was not going to lend money to kids. And who did we find out the person is?
The bank.
Yeah. Mr. Perkle admitted that if a responsible adult with a regular job and no debts came to ask for a loan with the same idea Rufus had, he'd probably get the money. I hope you understand, Mr. Perkle said. It's nothing against you personally. It's just that you're young. In your commercial, it says you encourage young businessmen, Rufus said. That stopped Mr. Perkle for a minute. Then he said, well, yes, we do. But what business experience have you ever had? Rufus has sold over 1,000 jars of toothpaste in 4 weeks, I said. Ah, Mr. Perkle said. And are you Mr. Mayflower's partner in business? She is a stockholder, Rufus said, which I thought was a very businesslike way to end the meeting. All right, chapter 15 is an exception to the rule about adults. So what was chapter 15 about?
It's about, but...
Go ahead.
There was a part in the beginning, he said, man, just because adults never believe kids, they think they can't do anything.
So that was in chapter 15?
Yeah, that's what
okay.
He said.
I agree with Ollie, because usually, what did you say, Ollie?
Adults don't believe kids.
Yeah, because sometimes this happened to me before. I asked my mom for $3. She said I can't give it to her. I asked her why. Because she said you're going to spend it. I told her I'm going to save it. But now I told my grandma, every single day, I told my grandma to pay me to do chores. And right now I have about 100 something.
Okay, so you're saving your money?
Yeah, I'm saving.
All right, I'll read chapter 15 just to review what's happened. Having made the point about adults never believing kids can do anything, I have to take that back, or at least to admit there are exceptions. Hector, for example. Who is Hector?
The personality.
The person that's staying at that factory to see if anybody
can.
All right. You want to add to it?
Hire him.
Okay. Okay, let Francisco add to that.
Hector is the one that is a mechanic.
Okay.
I forgot about that.
He's a mechanic. What else can we say about him? Okay. Anything else?
He's a person that makes a lot of money.
Does he make a lot of money?
Yeah.
It says, I don't know, but for sure, I know mechanics do make money.
But yes. In the book, does it say that he's making a lot of money? Go ahead.
It says that he is, but right now he's broke.
Okay, so how much money will he make if he gets paid?
Technically,
$9,000. And that's not a lot of money if you consider having five kids. Didn't he have five kids?
Yeah.
All right, so he's not a wealthy man.
But he said that's a good price.
If he had no kids at all.
It wouldn't be... I don't even think back in the 60s, $9,000 a year would be a lot, considered a lot.
How?
But to this day, it's a lot. Yeah.
It's not.
How?
The average person makes probably about $25,000 a year, would you say, Ms. Akins? 20 to 25?
I'd say 25,
30. $9,000 wasn't a lot of money, even back then. Having
what
made the point, but he didn't make a million.
What was that?
Yes. A million is a lot today.
Yeah, always have.
Okay, having made the point about kids never believing, adults never believing kids can do anything, I have to take that back, or at least to admit there are exceptions. Hector, for example. When what Rufus really felt bad about the afternoon we left Mr. Perkle's office was Hector. We'd have to tell him that we couldn't get the money. It doesn't matter about us, Rufus said. We can still make toothpaste in the laundry room, enough for our friends and families. But Hector really needs a job. And Hector was mad when we told him, furious. Stupid, 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 Hector said, stomping around the lot outside the factory. He was so mad he picked up a rock and heaved it against the wall of the factory. I thought at first he meant Rufus was stupid, or that he was stupid for believing Rufus could start a business, but he meant Mr. Perkle. Because you had a good idea, kid, he said to Rufus, a million-dollar idea. Just because you're only 12 years old doesn't mean it isn't a good idea. I've been in this business, and I can tell a good idea, and we've got the perfect machine for it, too. It's stupid to let that perfectly good machine stand there. It's a waste. It's a crime. It's stupid. Hey, Rufus suddenly brightened up as if he had a $10 million idea. Hector, he said, I believe you. I believe you would lend me the money if you had the money, that is. Believe me, I would, Hector said. Great, Rufus said. Then it's easy. All we've got to do, Hector, is for you to go to Mr. Perkle and ask him to lend you $15,000 to invest in a business. Me, Hector said. You, Rufus said. Why does Rufus think that Hector should go? Dontavious? Nice and loud.
Because Mr. Perkle said that if an adult with a regular job would come and have the same idea as Rufus, he would give him money.
Okay. Anybody want to add to that?
I do. It also said, I don't remember what it exactly says, but it also said that what basically what Don Tavia said, that you need to be older than you have to be 18 or older.
And it said that you had to have no something. What was it said? No. It's on page 81.
Oh, wait.
No.
I stopped reading at page 85, so.
Okay, so on the top of page 81, they were supposed to have no
debts.
What does that mean, no debts? No debts. So what would no debts mean?
You don't gotta pay them back.
Because why?
Because they didn't lend you the money.
Yeah, you never borrowed any money. Yeah, so you don't owe anybody anything.
And one time, I lived like right around the corner from Delaware. I went to go get some food for my parents. For them to cook. But I didn't have enough. I used my money
so she didn't make you pay her back. That was kind
of... That was the same thing when I got that little phone. It was 5 cents more. And then the woman in the media said they put 5 cents for me.
Okay. But that doesn't always happen, right? Yeah. Sometimes it doesn't. Yeah. Simple, Rufus said. I am going to hire you as manager of the toothpaste factory. The money you borrow to invest in the business, I can use to pay your first year's salary and to pay the rent and to buy some more toothpaste tubes, which we will probably need. Hector scratched his head. You mean I'm going to borrow the money and I'm going to invest it in your business so you can use it to pay me? Right, Rufus said. But that's not all. For the $15,000 you invest in the business, I will give you 150 shares of stock in the company. At the end of the year, you will get part of the profits of the company because you will be a major stockholder. A major stockholder, Hector said. Now, during that time, why would that have been unusual for someone like Hector to be a stockholder in the company?
I see the mechanic.
Okay, so his job, he was a mechanic. Anything else?
Mechanics aren't stockholders.
They could be.
Sometimes, but not all the time.
Okay. Was there anything else that would have possibly stopped him from being a stockholder in a business, possibly, at that time?
If he didn't have money.
Okay. What about the fact that he was a black man? Would that have stopped him?
No. Oh, yeah, it was back then, racist time.
Okay, so during segregation, so that...
Well, that's when it ended.
But it was ending, but it wasn't completely ended. So that's why Hector's, like, surprised when he says that. Rufus explained to Hector about the stock, that if Hector owned 150 shares of the stock, he'd own 15% of the business, and that if the company did make a $2.5 million profit, he'd get 15% of that, which would come to $375,000, Rufus said. That's more than enough to pay back the $15,000 to the Everybody's Friendly Savings and Loan. You sure you got that figured right, Rufus? Hector said. I told Hector we had checked out stockholders' profits in our math class. The whole class worked on it, and Mr. Conti checked the answers. Do it, Hector, I said. Go ask Mr. Perkle for the money. You mean I'd own part of the business, Hector said. Yep, Rufus said, and get paid every week, too. Oh, that would be beautiful, Hector said. Beautiful. There's just one question. Does this Mr. Perkle discriminate? I knew what Hector meant. As far as I know, just against kids, Rufus said. A year later, Hector said when he was being interviewed about Rufus on the Joe Smiley Show, maybe anybody can make toothpaste in his own kitchen, but speaking for myself, please join us. All I know is one day I'm a mechanic at work, out of work, and the next day I'm a general manager and major stockholder, and that takes genius. Hector believed Rufus was a genius from the beginning. When Mr. Perkle okayed the business loan to Hector, Hector handed the $15,000 check straight to Rufus. Rufus put the money in a bank account and wrote Hector a check for his first month's salary. My father claims that one of the best proofs of Rufus's genius was his hiring Hector to run the toothpaste factory. Of course, I have to remind my father, I was the one who discovered Hector. The nice thing about Rufus is that he always does remember that it was me who found Hector and the toothpaste machine. All right, turn it off. So...